Why did David not leave paradise? So at the end of Prometheus, David explained to Elizabeth Shaw that he could understand the engineer technology and pilot another ship. This was how he and Shaw escaped the moon LV-223. So after this, they spent some time together on this ship. They set a course to where the engineers came from, their homeworld called Paradise. So while LV-223 had more than one ship available, there was a good enough reason to believe their homeworld had plenty of ships, considering how many people were shown on the planet. So it left me wondering, if David wiped out the race of people on this planet, did he find other ships there? And if so, why did he not leave the planet sooner? Well, in the novel of Alien Covenant, there's a section of the story where David explains that while he was bombing the planet with the Black Goo pathogen, some engineers were aware of this attack and went on to disable the remainder of the ships on the planet. This was supposed to stop the pathogen from spreading off this world. So it seems some people on this planet were fully aware of what David was using on them and tried some type of fail-safe procedure to stop this person from using their weapons on other planets. Perhaps it could have been something programmed to affect all the ships on the planet. Now in the novel, there's even a part where the team discovers the fallen trees. While Anger suggests it could have been an asteroid, Daniel says that if it was an asteroid, it would have left a huge crater. Perhaps this is when David's ship was disabled and he tried to steer it, but then it landed on the side of a mountain amongst the trees. Now another thing that was in the novel was that they did scan the area for anything hazardous, but since the Black Goo was inactive at this point, their scans did not pick up anything, and this includes the spores on the planet. They were inactive until they become disturbed. They even took an extra precaution by sending out Walter to scan the atmosphere. After he discovers it's safe, the crew heads out. Later on, when they enter the Juggernaut ship, they come across smashed steatite ampules, which are the urns or vases that contain the Black Goo pathogen. And there is also neomorph mold growing around them. So when they saw these vases, this would have given the team enough warning signs that there could have been a contamination leak here, but they still proceeded inside. So with that information from the novel, that kind of explains what some fans were complaining about. If David could fly one ship, couldn't he have just taken another ship on their homeworld? And why was the crew so careless on an undiscovered planet? Now the novel did have quite a few differences from the film, and I feel that's the reason why some parts of the story felt unfinished. I prefer to have a well-explained story instead of bits and pieces that don't make sense or leave you wondering what happened. So hopefully those events make more sense now. So if you read the novel, how do you compare it to the film? Do you think the novel is better or is the film better? Put your answer in the comment section. To see more videos around the alien universe, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, my name is Carlos, and I'll see you in the next video.